So Jean-Luc is a specialist of quantum mechanics. So when he talks to me, I don't understand a word. But I hope you will understand, because he will give you a class, a lecture on the basics of physics. So it is my great pleasure to give him the mic, and maybe you will understand something. I hope I will.
1, 2, 3.
You good? Why talk about the standard model and beyond? In fact, the theoretical understanding of the cold fusion processes is very complex, because it seems to involve all the known interactions. It seems reasonable to place ourselves in the standard model, which totals the most knowledge and observation in the field of fundamental physics, with certainly the necessity to go beyond. We make a brief reminder of the standard model, reviewing the general concepts involved in the four fundamental interactions. We start from the classic Lagrangian mechanics and then guide you through essential developments leading to the model. It is coherent in its mathematical representation and describes very well what is observed. But some concepts seem beyond human understanding, where particular duality, interaction by exchange of virtual particles, the Higgs boson and mass, etc. I try to answer some legitimate questions in a natural way. The general frame in particular is the following. The formula called Lagrangian involves potentials which generate dynamics on moving objects. Theorem provides conservation laws from symmetry properties of the Lagrangian. The symmetry is the transformation of parameters, leaving it invariant. In particle theories, we look for transformation of potential called gauge transformation. Then we deduce by Noether's theorem invariant physical quantities judged as currents or charges. Here we consider fundamental interactions where potential act on matter made of fermions by means of mediator bosons. We formalize this by Lagrangian. Finally, we combine interaction and conservation law to build a convenient gauge theory for the interaction. First, the Lagrangian of classical mechanics. The question is, what's the minus sign between T and V? The answer is often, because it works. Of course, it's not satisfying. Here, I give a personal justification. If we look for the natural dynamics of a body subject to a potential, we just have to consider Newton's third law. From it, we can easily deduce T minus V must be stationary along the path taken by the body. This is a little calculus. At the same time, we arrive at the principle of least action called also principle of stationary action, the earth of analytical mechanics. We deduce Euler Lagrange's equations of motion. In the given example, we can easily fall back on Newton's second law. Note the concept of conjugate momentum and the Hamiltonian representing the total energy deduced from the Lagrangian. Einstein said, Noether's theorem is a monument of mathematical fugue. Few people know Noether was a woman, Emmy Noether. We give examples in classic mechanics of conservation laws associated with symmetries. We move on to classic field theory where the introduction of special relativity implies considering space-time coordinate. We introduce new object, we introduce new abstract object, the fields, function defined on in all space-time. Then the Lagrangian is replaced by a space density. Instead of coordinates and temporal derivatives, the parameters of Lagrangian are fields and the space-time derivatives. We give here an example of Lagrangian for a scalar field associating a number with each point of the space-time and containing a mass term. We can still recognize the dynamic term in red with time derivative and a potential term in blue with space derivative. Note the Lagrangian of the theory is not unique. With quantization, we pass an important step. The first one is quantum mechanics, where quantization concerns the value of physical parameters, energy level, state, etc., associated with quantum numbers. Moreover, the dynamics or the presence of a quantum object is represented by a wave function. The algebra of commutators with the concept of conjugate variables come from analytical mechanics. See in the slide 4. Recall, for a quantum object, the probability density of presence is given by the square of its wave amplitude. Algebraic physical quantities are represented by quantum operators. Commutators applied to the operator are used to specify properties like the possibility or not of simultaneous measure for two physical quantities. Note the calculation formula of average value of an operator, very important. Then the second, called the second quantization, leading to quantum field theory. In fact, we quantize the number of particles in quantum state of field. Operators are defined on the field and field operator. But then the wave function involves operators for creation or destruction of particles. Commutators can be applied to fields and fields operator, but only for boson fields. For fermions, represented by spinner solution of Dirac equation, we have to use anti-commutators because of Fermi-Dirac statistics. Note the very important concept of vacuum expectation value of a quantum operator involved in a spontaneous symmetry breaking and for defining interaction probator to see at slide of moreover, note the theorem. The Noether's theorem is extended to quantum fields to obtain current and charge conservation. Now we look at interacting fields. We consider the first historic interaction theory, the quantum electrodynamics. It describes interaction between fermions field driven by electromagnetic fields. The mediator bosons are photons. We can see the Lagrangian for free Dirac spinner, next for electromagnetic field, here. And the interaction Lagrangian built with psi spinner and a four vector potential. From a specific gauge, we deduce a covariant derivative to build a Lagrangian invariant for the gauge. We can recognize a dynamic term in red and a potential term in blue. Here. QED is the basis of all of the QFT. The standard model has been able to predict many phenomena with great accuracy. QED is a witness of choice, where the fine structure constant and the magnitude moment of the electron was predicted with a relative accuracy of 10 power minus 8. In quantum field theory, the goal is to calculate the amplitude of state transition for given interactions. The perturbation method can be applied in QED in form of series of operator products, where the successive terms give result of increasing accuracy. But direct calculation by hand are very tedious. Then Feynman genius led to diagrams to represent interaction. In fact, it is a graphic coding of interaction. It's not a reality. Next application of Feynman rules correspond to program execution, directly providing the transition amplitude in algebraic expression. Here we give example of Lopez diagram, the diagram of Baba interaction, where two diagrams code the possible interaction between an electron and a positron. M is the algebraic expression of total amplitude of transition obtained by means of Feynman rules. It contains all the involved operators and propagators parameterized by momenta. Note the particles at the output, F plus and F minus at the right, depend on the input energies. So if energies are high enough, we can have quarks or hadrons at the outputs. Here we give a heuristic explanation for a legitimate question. How can a change of virtual photons cause a repulsion or an attraction between particles? We consider a transfer of 3D momenta. For attraction, this momentum is negative. It's strange, but it's not heretic, because a virtual photon is not a physical particle. It's a fleeting perturbation of the field. So a virtual particle can violate the energy moment relations thanks to Heisenberg time energy relation. Loops pose a big problem to the initial theory because they can imply divergent integrals. And the renormalizing process was for a long time considered as a fate of time until the Kenneth Wilson work on the renormalization group connected with the top theory of critical phenomena and phase transition, which earned him the Nobel Prize. I wrote in bold what is essential for even an idea of the process. Note the important beta function, expressing the dependence of coupling on energy. When beta function is positive, perturbation method can be used. Now we review the strong nuclear force formalized by quantum chromodynamics, a gauge theory where the product of transformation are not commutative. We give reasons justifying the introduction of new shards conveniently represented by the three primary colors in additive synthesis. The antiquarks carry anticolor charts represented by complementary colors. And so the beta function is negative, associated with observed strange properties, color confinement and asymptotic freedom. Interaction between quarks is mediated by gluons, which carry color charge too, one color and one anticolor. This leads to interaction between gluon too, thus a great complexity in the calculation. We can see a condensed form of the Lagrangian with still a dynamic and a potential term. At low energy, long distance, the strong coupling in color confinement prevents using perturbative method. But there is a very promising method in the world, that is a QCD, where quarks are at the vertices and gluons on the edges. The calculations are very complex. On the other hand, at high energy, small distance, the weak coupling in asymmetric freedom allows to apply perturbative methods. Finally, what concerns us most is the so-called residual nuclear interaction between nucleons. We got a very promising analytical model allowing to go beyond the numerous factual models. It provides the magic numbers, the nuclear magic momenta, and the collective rotation. However, it requires a lot of computing power. In fact, representation in algebra geometry could allow vertiginous reduction of analytical expressions. We note the arcane amplitude drone, shortcutting hundreds of QCD Feynman diagrams. The weak nuclear interaction was very difficult to formalize because of its not usual characteristic indicative error. But it fertilized the X-field hypothesis. In general, the mass of interaction boson is inversely proportional to the range of interaction. The O-axis range is very low, of -10^-17. One can predict the bosons of weak interaction are very high masses, 80 to 90 gigaelectron volts. Note the range mass relation is not true for gluons with no interact with the X field. Here we can see a diagram of interaction between the no particles and with the X field. The last sentence about mass is an essential property of X field. We pass quickly on the gravitational interaction with the equation of general relativity obtained by the brilliant intuition of Einstein. Here, the equation can also be deduced from a Lagrangian of differential geometry in a very simple form, but very complex calculus. We note the most famous attempt to quantization, string theory, and loop gravity. We finish by going through the most interesting part, the open or almost solved problems. The experimental success of standard model invites to continue to use it to enlighten new research, for example, on the cold fusion, which then led to complete the standard model by new concept and scenario. Many experiments are currently programmed. We note the EMC effect with some attempt of explanation. A modification on nuclear mean field because of fields of neighboring quarks or temporary formation of pair of nucleons. Two pairs of about light hadrons that seem to be almost solved by lattice QCD. Not also the constituent or dynamical quark model invoking a spontaneous quark symmetry breaking in QCD. Here is a long list of various unsolved issues. I'll do have a look. Then a very mediatic subject, neutrino oscillation, with the conjecture of Cicero mechanism. The explanation of oscillation is simple if the neutrinos of non-zero masses and different according to the flower, electron, muon, and tau. As a consequence, we have a combination of three different wavelengths, thus interference causing oscillation on a long path. Some words about current theoretical and experimental research methods to overcome the standard model. In particular, the physics of hidden sectors where new particles are very weakly coupled to a sort of standard model of interaction portals. It seems the particles called actions or action-like are very promising. Now, some idea of the method of portals using Lagrangian of interaction with particles beyond the standard model. Dark photon, dark neutrino, and also the model of action portal. For the fun, an overview of the Lagrangian for standard model, very concept in only one page. The lines correspond with gauge bosons, dynamical and mass terms, all the terms of standard model. Here, some references easy to find. We note near the bottom, this a very interesting recent study about reality under the quantum wave function. Thanks for your attention. I made a poster for eventual discussion for more easy for the question. But
okay, thanks for a very interesting presentation. At the end, you said that axioms are very interesting.
Yes.
And there's a large proportion of the Russian low energy nuclear reactor research community that think they're very important. So I have two questions.
Yes.
One, what is an axion?
What is an axion?
And two, what happens when it gets exposed to an intense magnetic field?
Is an action is a hypothetical particle which could be weakly associated interaction associated with some particle in the standard model, but its parameters are not known with precisely because there is an unknown. This is just hypothesis.
So I think that
it's interesting to adapt well to the interaction with a standard model. It's possible, but it is very, very difficult to detect. And some experiment with a large computer consists to do experiment to see if it exists.
And so you don't know what will happen when it's exposed to an intense magnetic field.
Okay, donc on ne sait pas ce qui arrive si une attraction elle est soumise à un champ magnétique intense.
Possibly, I don't know, we don't know.
Thanks a lot, Jean-Luc. You had 30 slides, and I guess that each slide would be served 1 hour, if not one day, to follow you. So, you know, maybe one more. And but I saw also the hypothesis of quark mixture.
Quark?
Living quark mixture. I think my is
mixture.
Mixture.
What is the question about quark mixture?
This is interesting. This is an hypothesis or experiments that show something like this.
It's the possible explanation for some awareness of observation. Presently there is experiment here called collider. We give the It seems there are a mixture of four quarks, pentaquarks, and even at very high temperature, you get the soup to where the soup, comment in soup, and a soup of quarks, quarks and gluons. But it's what certainly saw in the early age of the universe, when temperature was higher than the electroweak temperature. The electroweak temperature is the time corresponds to with the time where electromagnetism and weak interaction was initiated. And after the temperature decreased, and it was the time of the quarks. Because the quarks were not yet unit in hadrons. And when the temperature decreases, the quark can be bound but in general, that is a real problem. It's to understand why all the particles, the sub particles, exist by three. Three are with mere masses different, but we can see what relationship between these masses and the family of the particle is not ordered. Is spiritual.
Because the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you.
I mean, all for a means for tonight's question to someone who wants to ask tonight.
What is
it?
What is
it? Okay,
sure.
Yes.
Reported about the large amount of this magic how you measure or determine this power that you have said.
Okay.
How was
the method is just thermometry, not calorimetry. So I use a thermometer because it's fast. We make calibration using the same device, all the same, everything same, and just giving conditioning time shorter, not 58 hours, but a specific measurement 3 hours, and that's down. Anyway, I wait always for equilibrium time. So I impose that in such short conditioning, very short, it is hour zero. So we keep number of temperature outside, inside just for the
reference and then compared to the
yes, yes. And then it's the very simple formula, very simple formula. The temperature active minus temperature of reference divide temperature of reference multiply for the input power. That be is the data I will root. Very, very simple.
Okay,
it's systematic. Simple. So we just make with the true data fitting second, only second for the fitting, low level fitting, just to see better. So we can no stupid, not very realistic.
But this, I understand that you can calculate how much power you have produced.
Yes.
Additionally, yeah. But let's find they determine all the whole situation in your experiment.
In some way.
What parameter?
Example, we say in some stable condition, but 100 bar just with an idea. When it's all flat, all stable, all, I take off immediately, roughly, the power supply, I disconnect, and I measure the voltage coming out from the wire. It has to be zero, but it's not zero, number different. They are a few millivolts, the range, but we can measure very easily because in this condition. And this voltage decrease over time, not just a moment, but over time decreasing the temperature of inside of the reactor. It correlated, so it's
over the decrease of the temperature.
Decrease. So usually I wait 1 minute, 2 minutes, not more, because it's not important. Otherwise, if I wait too much, the system lose the capability to have large, because it's the next step at a lower power. So I make typically 55 minutes of high power, few seconds, maximum 1 minute without power, and that I reduce from 100 to 90 watts, and again I repeat sequentially up to zero. And I compare the data with the reference that has done the same treatment. Really simple way, very conservative. So I think there is no mistake. Also because the spontaneous voltage is completely related to the excess power calculated by elementary formula. And moreover, if we make simple calculations using the Ohm law, the real voltage coming out from the wire is put in high intervals. It's not only few millivolts, but larger, very, very large amount of voltage. So, the next experiment is thinking to change to the true voltage coming out from the wire. We have very rapidly, it's just one experiment. So, one last day before coming here. So, just one test. And we keep connecting the ground of the wire. And I measure the voltage with the counter electrode, and I measure about 3 volts. So we larger. But yesterday I make some more calculation better. And if I don't make mistake in the calculation, considering the current, so simple representing a formula. The true voltage over chicken is over 500 volts. Over. So we don't understand why so large. I give power 50 volts. Disconnect, but the true voltage 500. We have to keep the wire.
I got something similar with a centimeter long.
Yes.
In hydrogen. When the heat in hydrogen.
Yes. Oh, very good. So we can send the data. I give you all my data. If you have time, we can discuss it. Thanks a lot. And maybe be similar in a way to the experiment. Remember when Fabrice,
sorry.
But the true number was not I use the warm-up condition to measure, because one side is grounded.
Okay.
The 3 million, 5 years old, just was surviving. To the belly, that's because racer, this young wire resistance. But one grounded, so the current go to zero, go to ground. But even some millivolts may be forever. The true voltage is higher. Okay, I hope in some weeks to give you the true numbers coming out.
But I'm vicino al microfono.
Oh, scusate. Okay, I think that's it. The true number, I have indication.
Okay.
That the true number coming out from the Y by, because calculation, the regular calculation is of the order of over 500 volts. So we don't understand why we have some very bad idea. So at the moment, it's better to be silent, because otherwise you will touch me with wood. Okay.
Questo è scusi se mi permetto.
Ok.
Però forse se fate il grafico, mi sono stato per esempio che la loro la
conversione. Vediamo un pochino. Ah, ok, è troppo tardi, ok. Ah, vabbè, faccio vedere con la... Ok, thanks for the suggestion, but I think now it's possible to... Anyway, very, very simple project. Reliable. In 2012-13, sometimes we observe such effort, but was out of our control. We cannot make a systematic study. So we think correlated, but not sure. Impossible to show to other people, just ourselves. So maybe Bob and Mathieu Remember thought, oh, very nice.
I
don't
know. My one moment. Thank you.
The evaluation, I
tried to do something in the voltage
that is...
Can you speak louder?
When I evaluated the spontaneous voltage creation in your system, it was in 2014, something like that.
Yes.
I wasn't sure that, but it is with you.
Yeah.
Okay.
But my conclusion were... my conclusion is that the evidence of voltage production is real. We don't know the electrical response being able to be created. And the possibility that it's coming from a permanent, some electricity-based effect is still there. I'm still not sure about it.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, go.
La firma, dove sta?
La firma, la firma.
Qual è la firma? Aspetto?
Yes,
hi, my name is Bob Grinier. I'm a volunteer with the Martin Fleischmann Memorial Project.
Oh.
I don't need that. It's not broadcasting anyway. So I hope I can wake you up just before our photo. Oh, no. Yeah, that's good. Thank you. Okay, you need to hear me. Here we go. And the laser pointer, lovely. So this presentation.